Hello, I'm Penny Reeve, and in the other box is Cecily Paterson, and we are the authors of the Pet Sitter books. We write as Ella Shine, mainly because we couldn't fit our both of our names on the front cover of the books, but also because we wanted a pen name that was sort of sparkly and fun, and so Ella Shine is what we ended up with. Gus Makes a Fuss was the first book in our series. Cecily, you have written other books before, haven't you?
Yes, so mostly I've written for girls a bit older than the 8-year-old age group that Pet Sitters is for, so like 11 to 15-year-olds, and I've written some adult memoir and biographies as well.
So me picking you to write with was a good choice because you've got lots of experience.
Oh, was it? Maybe. Because here I am writing for much older children, and you've written for much younger children, so I guess we've brought a mix together. I don't know. Anyway, I think it works quite well.
I think so too. Can you remember how we came up with our idea to write together? Because we'd never, you hadn't done this before, and I hadn't done this before either.
No, as in I hadn't written books for younger children. In fact, I hadn't written books for children at all. I think I wrote a few picture books when I had young children, but everyone writes a picture book when they have a young child, when
Yes,
they're a writer,
yes.
and it wasn't very good, probably. So we became friends at some point, and I think we were sitting around talking about the books that we write and the books that our children read, because I think about that time we had probably had a 6 to 8-year-old each, or somewhere around there, and we both had older children as well who'd gone through and read a whole lot of books, and we thought, you know what, those sorts of chapter books that you get 50 million of in the same series, like, the kids love them. We're
They're
kind of
so
sick of reading them.
boring.
It
Sometimes,
would be
oh.
fun to write our own so that maybe we wouldn't get bored reading them. So then we decided to go, we started brainstorming, like, oh, what could we write about? And we came up with a few things. And then we happened on the grumpy talking cat, which is turned out to be Gus. And I think the giggles started. And honestly, that's been the most fun thing about writing this series, is writing a character who literally just says whatever's on his mind, and he doesn't care about being nice to anybody, and he's hilarious. So we have found certain parts of our personalities have enjoyed that very much.
And funnily, we're both actually dog people, not cat, not
Yes,
cats.
not cat people at all.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the dogs don't even get a look in.
No. Well, that's true. We haven't written one about a dog yet, because in each
Not
book they pet sit a different animal. So for people who aren't familiar with the series, the first book they get to meet Gus, and they have to pet sit him. And even though he's so grumpy and he says whatever comes into his mind, he's really quite insecure, isn't he? He just
He's an insecure little softy at heart who just wants to be loved, and he
Yes.
just tests everybody's boundaries all the time. But he is very lovable, and the girls do love him very much. So it all works out in the end.
Then in book two, they end up pet sitting a guinea pig who happens to turn invisible. And of course, Gus is incredibly jealous. And so chaos
But he
happens
kind
there
of ends up
too.
being jealous. He ends up being jealous of almost every pet that they pet
He
sit.
does.
But he still takes part, and then he starts a problem, and then he ends up sort of kind of solving the problem with or for the girls. So like he has a little conscience, poor
He
little
does,
darling.
the poor little thing, and in a funny way. So there's that. We've got a miniature pony. That was Cecily's idea. She really likes miniature ponies. I stood up for the reptiles, and so we've got a bearded dragon in this book here. Train Trouble, which was the previous release, has some mice which multiply. We had a lot of fun coming up with the
That
names of
was
the mice.
hilarious.
That was really
Yes,
fun.
ice coming out of everywhere.
And so our new book, would you say it's our favorite?
So, look, I've enjoyed every book that we've written more than the previous books, which isn't saying that I didn't enjoy the previous books, but the enjoyment has grown, I think, as we've developed more ridiculous things for the animals to get involved with. In this one, that's right. So the girls and Gus are pet sitting a goat this time, and they are going to take part in the filming of a goat's milk soap commercial in their
That's a
town. Their
mouthful,
town is
isn't it? Goat's milk
Springs.
soap commercial.
Yes, I have to concentrate to say that. Goat's milk soap commercial. But this came about because in the town where I lived, which is a little town down on New South Wales' south coast, it was quite a popular spot for various things to get filmed. And I actually took part as an extra in the filming of a movie in the town where we were, together with my daughter, who was, I think, 7 at the time. And so
did you have to dress up?
We had to dress up, yeah. We had costumes, we had makeup, and it was a period piece as well. So it was good fun. But I thought, wouldn't it be cool for the girls to go and be extras, as it turns out, starring roles in this thing that's being filmed in their little town, just like it was in my little town.
That's a cool thing. Like when you're writing books, you can draw on your own story and put things in. So, yeah, we definitely borrowed from your experience with that. And the girls have to get Gus, who comes along with them everywhere, and there's Billy Goat, to the TV commercial. And there's a lot of funny things that happen along the way as we find
there's
out.
There's some rambunctiousness.
Yes, we can't say too much, can we?
No.
People have to
things go wrong.
I think one of the fun things about writing this is we sit down and we plan what goes wrong, and then when we come to actually writing it, the way that we write is that someone writes chapter one and someone writes chapter two. Can you remember who wrote chapter one for Billy Goat Boogie?
No, I honestly can't remember. But it kind of doesn't matter, because the way we do it, one, it doesn't matter who starts. So we have the plan for the chapters. We know there's going to be 10 chapters. We know what's going to happen in each chapter. And then one person gets assigned chapter one and they write the draft and they send it through to the other one. And the other person rips it to shreds and edits it completely and adds
so many red squiggly lines and all sorts of stuff happens.
And then writes chapter two. And so two chapters go back to the next person who goes, I will now do my bits to it. And so rips that to shreds and writes the next one. And so by the time it gets through to chapter 10, we've both seen it at least 6 times each. And we've both added to it. So it's actually not Penny's voice and it's not my voice. It's actually a very seamless mix of both our voices, which is different from what we individually write as well.
Yeah. So that's where Ella Shine comes to life. In
Ella
really.
Shine shines.
Yes. One of the things I enjoy is when I'm reading through the comments and you might say something like, this really doesn't work. And then later on it's like, this is too wordy and you'll fix it for me. And then later on it'll be like, I just almost wet my pants laughing. You know, because we end up writing and imagining what's happening and our imagination takes over and it just becomes hilarious writing. And apparently the illustrator said she was giggling her head off when she was illustrating this one as well.
Oh, was she?
Yeah.
That's a success, so I think.
I think the readers are going to like it. And
yeah,
because we try to make sure the adults don't get bored too, they're really important. Yeah.
Oh, and we have a subscription service coming so that you can sign up and you can get all the books, one a month, perfectly for your young reader to read one and then go, "Where's the next one?" And lo, it will arrive.
That's the good thing about serious fiction. You've got them hooked and then, you're moving on from one book to the other, and it can be quite stressful as a parent trying to get the right books. So we've made it easy for you with this subscription service. So if you like the sound of these books, look them up. You can find them at www.ellashineauthor.com. I'll put some details in the comments.